Good morning. So we'll make the summary of art, art sessions. The topics this year were how can we improve accuracy of rejection diagnosis and biopsies, QT effect, current knowledge and questions, and minimal inflammation. First part of the workshop, we had a presentation of several techniques with a promising input in the diagnosis and in studies for cardiac rejection. First was the use of digital pathology presented by Elliot Peister from Basberg. He showed, interestingly, that he was able with a computer and algorithm to detect on cardiac biopsies foci of lymphocytes and was able to discriminate non-rejecting and rejecting biopsy and also to discriminate high-grade versus low-grade rejection. And he said that we need now to improve the diagnosis and assessment of biopsy for diagnosis and research by using this digital pathology with a modern algorithm. Next speaker presented the phenotyping of inflammatory cells using multiplex immunofluorescence on cardiac biopsies presenting cellular rejection and antibody-mediated rejection. We were able to detect by this technique on the same section T lymphocytes, macrophages, and NK cells, determining if these cells are within or out vessels by using an integral marker. We were able also to count the cells, showing that the total inflammatory burden was increased during rejection and mainly during cellular rejection. That the cells were present both, NK cells were present both in antibody-mediated rejection and cellular rejection. But the compartmentalization of NK cells was different, mainly intravascular in antibody-mediated rejection and mainly extravascular in cellular rejection. Another profile was that the most prominent cells, both in cellular and antibody-mediated rejection, was T lymphocytes and not macrophages, even in intravascular location. The third speaker presented molecular assessment as a companion to histopathology in heart transplantation. He showed that now the tendency is to limit the number of genes and use targeted gene expression in tissue and for study and diagnostic purpose to move to paraffin embedded tissue and to use as a companion test molecular biology to improve the diagnosis by histopathology. So now we have to select, targeted genes, for molecular pathology, and the best technique to make this molecular study seems to be nanostring technique. Next speaker was Marnie Frédrigo from Padova University, studying vasculitis during rejection. Vasculitis is a special pattern that is observed in some biopsies, inflammation of venules, arterioles, and small arteries, like that. And she did modeling of this pathological observation, confronting this inflammation of vessels to pathologic conditions like death, cardiac allograft, vasculopathy, cellular rejection, and so on. And she showed finally that we have to take into account, when you read the biopsy, we have to take into account vascular inflammation, and that in both cellular and antibody-mediated rejection, vascular damage has been associated with a severe form of rejection, and mainly when the inflammation involves arteries. And last speaker of this, for this topic was Ornella Leon from Bologna, speaking about injury in the myocardium. In fact, injury in the myocardium depends on many causes, before, during, early after, and late after transplantation. And there are many causes, so it's difficult to, by just a simple observation at microscope or using molecular microscope to determine that it is rejection or non-rejection. So we have to integrate the conservation of myocyte damage into the background. One cause, but not the single one, is ischemic damage, frequently observed in the early phase post-transplantation in the setting of primary graft dysfunction. So the concept of cardiac injury in pathology is broad with multiple facets and etiology. Second part of the workshop was about the Quilty effect. What is Quilty effect? This was presented by Charles Barbeau from New York. Quilty effect is this lesion. It's a follicle nodule within the endocardium of the graft. 4 years, more than 30 years, this Quilty effect is known, and nobody knows the significance of this lesion. And in addition, this lesion represents a pitfall for the diagnosis at biopsy. Some studies have analyzed this immune response chemistry of this lesion, but without clear results. We presented also the report that the molecular study, a very old technique which is named AlloMap. It's a non-invasive test, molecular test from the leukocytes, very old, before the era of antibody-mediated rejection. But this old test, AlloMap, was able to distinguish people developing Quilty effect and make the difference from people with rejection and non-rejection. Gregory Fischbach made a review of literature on the Quilty effect with the question, is it rejection or not? Finally, the literature is not conclusive, no decision about acute cellular rejection and Quilty, about antibody-mediated rejection and Quilty, and no link, no obvious link between Quilty and cardiac arrhythmias. What's probably certain is that Quilty effect is not associated with a worse prognosis in terms of survival. Delsenil presented the hypothesis that Quilty effect should be, or could be, a tertiary lymphoid follicle. And she presented in the review of the literature that some studies have shown that some markers of tertiary lymphoid follicle are present within Quilty effect lesions, like high endothelial venules. We know that in the heart, not in the endocardium, but in the heart, myocardium, and mainly in the epicardium around coronary artery, mainly coronary artery developing cardiac allograft, it's frequent to observe such lymphoid follicles. So there is a tendency to make a parallel between these Quilty effect lesions and tertiary follicles observed around coronary arteries. These pericoronary follicles produce antibodies. At the end of the presentation of Quilty effect, the group decided to perform a pilot study of Quilty effect. The rationale is that Quilty effect or endocardial lymphoid nodules are present on biopsies, interfere with the diagnosis of rejection, and are of unknown significance, rejection or no. The aim of the study is to determine if Quilty is rejection, acute or chronic, or just a tertiary lymphoid follicle by using molecular analysis on downstream platforms and digital pathology, including immunohistochemistry and multiplex learning. Participants are in Europe, these centers with a central lab in Paris, and in North America, these teams, and with a central lab in Edmonton. The study will be performed on paraffin blocks. And finally, during the breakfast symposium on the minimal inflammation, Jean-Paul Duong presented minimal inflammation in heart transplantation. What to do with it? Is it rejection, or is it depending on non-rejection process like QT effect, previous biopsy site, ischemic damage, infection, and so on? In his study, he presented a grading system of in the setting of antibody-mediated rejection, a grading system of microvascular inflammation in the heart, and in the low-grade inflammation, MV1, he considered that it was a pattern of low-grade inflammation in antibody-mediated rejection. He made correlation with a transcript expression, and interestingly, we show that this low-grade one of inflammation is associated with increased expression of genes involved in rejection, like endothelial cell gene, NK genes, and macrophagic gene. So, minimal inflammation is not always rejection, but if you rule out other cause, it is rejection, and minimal inflammation in heart allograft may reflect low-grade rejection with molecular activation of the cells. Sustained minimal rejection may reflect graft immune and chronic injury. However, there is no yet convincing data on the effect of low-grade rejection on global survival and progression of cardiac allograft vasculopathy. In conclusion, the group said that still now, skilled and subtle histopathology remain the basis for entry in the studies and in the real life of diagnosis. However, there is a confirmed input of molecular analysis for study, and probably soon as a major diagnostic help under the conditions that molecular studies are performed on the same tissues as the histopathology, under the control of the view to avoid non-relevant tissue blindly harvested by the biopsy. Promising molecular techniques of paraffin tissue exist, and mainly it's nanostring technique. And third, we observe now the arrival of new techniques in morphology. It's digital pathology, multiplex labeling for morphological analysis of biopsy. Indeed, now it's limited to research to studies, but possibly it will be a diagnostic help in the future by new algorithms or artificial intelligence. Thank you.